Hi there. On this episode of CRR Week, we're going to be talking about engineering. My name is Chris Brunette. I'm the Chief of Fire and Life Safety with the Colorado Division of Fire Prevention and Control.
And I'm Wendy Giannini King from the Wilmington, North Carolina Fire Department. I'm the Community Risk Reduction Coordinator for WFD. And we are talking this week, as Chris said, about engineering. And usually in the fire service, when we think about engineering, we're thinking about sprinklers and smoke alarms and alarm systems, but the COVID pandemic has really made the fire service think outside the box when it comes to engineering and the E of engineering for prevention. And that's what we're here to talk about today. What do you think about the engineering of the COVID pandemic, Chris?
Yeah, thanks, Wendy. It's just been a very interesting year. Typically, when we talk about engineering, we're thinking about those highly technical things like fire alarm systems and sprinkler systems and applying those to our communities to reduce the risk. But look at what we're doing now. Here we are basically a continent apart from one another, and we're enjoying one another's company. And so we've really started to use these virtual platforms like Zoom and Google Meets and those type of things to really get our word and education out. So I'm very proud of the industry and how we've adapted and started to reach out to our communities using these technologies. How about in Wilmington, have you guys, what have you been doing new this year because of the pandemic?
Well, first of all, let me just jump back to something you said and the shout out that we're literally a country apart from each other and here face to face. And not only is the platform of Zoom happening right now, but these awesome backgrounds too, right? That's a part of this whole engineering thing also. Check out our new CRR Week backgrounds. But in Wilmington, we have done, and we did a little clip like this earlier, about foster care inspections being virtual. So either via Zoom or Skype or Teams or FaceTime even has made us really think outside the box. I have to say that when it comes to the technological engineering that's been happening over the pandemic, that I feel like it's efficient. Certainly you're missing the face-to-face, the face-to-face interaction and the nuances of being in the company of another person, but the efficiency, I think, can't be beat.
No, it's true. I think what we're doing now is really going to change the world going out into the future. I mean, even once we get past the pandemic, I think a lot of what we learned through this pandemic, we're going to end up utilizing moving forward. I know, you know, with my team, we do inspections across Colorado, both fire and building inspections. And, you know, it's a big state to try and traverse, especially if you just have maybe a roof inspection that's 400 miles away across the state. And so to be able to do a virtual inspection has really made what we do more efficient and more effective and you know, getting people those inspections sooner. And you know, if it all goes well, we can leave it at that. But if there's something that kind of trips us up, then we can send somebody out still. But really, it's something that I think we're going to continue to use. So, there's just all these little bits of engineering that we're just now learning how to use, and I think it's just going to continue to progress.
Well, and what I've seen through our fire marshal's office and the coordination with building and planning and zoning in the city and then also the county that we live in is that we were headed towards a computer-based, a virtual almost platform to begin with. We've been learning how to do plan reviews online and those kinds of things. So really, this was a trial by fire, but the writing was on the wall anyway, right? So that we recognized that there was a way to coordinate without having to sit in, you know, 1,000 meetings, lengthy meetings a week. So now the inspectors can look at the construction plans online at their desk or at their house or wherever they are. So this whole technological revolution that's kind of just happened fast was a trial by fire, but I feel like it was coming anyway. Do you agree?
I completely agree. And not only are our plan reviewers able to do their plan reviews regardless of where they're at, but now we're using a platform where they're able to put in real-time comments, and people in the field, our inspectors in the field, are able to see those comments real-time. And so you can have somebody looking at a set of plans while somebody's on site inspecting. It's the technology has just come a long way, and I'm so glad that we have it available to us. I think it's beneficial for us and for all of our stakeholders. So it's been great. You know, I do want to speak a little bit to this being our second CRR week. I think the technology has really helped to progress what we're going to be doing this year with CRR week. I think we did a pretty good CRR week last year. Yes. But this year, I'm just very excited about everything that we're preparing because we're employing that technology. And so I've got team members who are just planning several videos, and we're able to put those videos out each day and talk about each of the five E's. And so I think this is just another way that we're going to reach that larger audience. So what about you guys? What are you planning for CRR Week?
Well, we're going to keep ours top secret for right now, but because things are so different than they were last year, and because CRR Week really is fire service facing, we're going to be utilizing manpower within WFD to really drive home the point of the five E's and how we can kind of adapt and overcome when it comes to this new world we're living in, to still meet the mark when it comes to each one of those five E's. We, in thinking about engineering today, engineering as technology, right? The Facebook, the social media, the videos that we've had to produce, because we had the technology, we just weren't embracing it fully yet. So we're able to do all of our five E's, or most of them, right, via technology, via the internet, thinking about economic incentive, which is a bit off of our engineering path. But if we're talking about freebies, we've been able to create, and we will for CRR Week, this is behind the curtain peek, be able to give some freebies away through games and, you know, and yeah, Facebook kinds of efforts. So I'm super excited about that.
No, that sounds fantastic. I can't wait. I'm looking forward to seeing what all you're going to do, Wendy. You know, that reminds me, there's a CRR team here in Colorado with South Metro Fire Rescue. And they pointed out to me early on that one way that they really reach a younger audience is they use Bitmojis. And so I've looked into that, and it's just a really good way to connect with the younger audience and get your message across. So I don't know if you've started using the Bitmojis, but it's just another example of engineering and technology that you can use to reach that specific audience if you'd like.
It's true, and I've not tried this myself, but I've been watching the Fire and Life Safety Educators Group and several real pioneers when it comes to virtual classrooms. So the E for education doesn't have to be lost because we're not in person. There are still some techniques out there and some technologies and bits of engineering that are going to be super helpful moving forward when it comes to education.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. And I just want to touch on that point. You know, we've talked about not being able to be in person, but there are some times where we are in person. And since we're talking about engineering, I just want to kind of touch on that in person. When we do meet in person, you know, right now we're wearing masks. And if you think about it, that is a little bit of engineering right there. Early on, we figured out that the masks with the external valves really weren't good, and that the cloth masks were good. And so it was an evaluation, an assessment, and then we applied what we learned to the engineering. And now we're learning that the masks are probably pretty good for containing this virus. So just another idea for how engineering works in our CRR efforts.
And to expand on that, really, what you just said is kind of a foundation of CRR in general, is just the trial and error, right? I mean, put it out there, and if it doesn't work, try a new path. And if that doesn't work, tweak it and try something new, right? So if your first attempts with any of these technologies, these engineering efforts, don't quite work the way you think they will, right? Go back a step and tweak your strategy, tweak your implementation plan, and try it again, right?
Yeah. Go ahead, Wendy.
Oh, thank you. I was going to say, and a side note, I was thinking also about all the other places in our state and in our country that have really had to try something new, not just the fire service, but the DMV and doctor's offices with telemedicine, right? Things like getting a haircut. Now you can't just walk in, you wait in your car and text that you're here. So this is across the board, a whole new front when it comes to technological engineering. And I don't think that some of it will go away if we ever do get back to some sort of normal. I think that we've just created for ourselves new tools for our toolboxes that will stay in whatever the new world looks like.
I couldn't agree with you more. I think that we've entered a new world, and we're going to be more efficient and more effective because we have these new tools. So I really do think it's real, like you said, a feet to the fire proof that we were forced to engineer new concepts and new methods for doing what we do. And I think we've been successful, and we'll continue to be successful because of it.
I agree. It's not all bad, but I will say at the very beginning there, I was a little bit nervous when March rolled around and we were all kind of sent to a quiet place for a minute. I thought, how is this going to work? How is this going to work for someone that's very outreach oriented? I really had to make myself move to the 21st century, because I knew these technologies were available, just hadn't ever been brave enough to try them. So I'm glad that this has happened in a way to move us forward and to connect us a little better. I've been having these great meetings, participating in these great meetings that are across the country in California that have to do with youth fire setters. I don't know if because of COVID is the reason that I learned about them, or if it was a brave new effort just coincidentally at the same time, but I feel more connected to you all, to the people around the country working in the same field that I am, than ever before.
Absolutely. Yeah, I can't agree with you more. I'm in Zoom calls daily, and it's not just Zoom calls with people from Colorado. It's people from all over the country and sometimes internationally. There's been some really good connections made with our Canadian partners, and so they do a lot with CRR as well. And so I think that we've really come a long way to become, more efficient and connected, at least nationally, if not internationally. So
I agree. Well, to sum it all up, I think what we've learned is that engineering is technology, right? That the technological engineering of things like smoke alarms and alarm systems and sprinklers that have been traditional forms of engineering when it comes to risk reduction, have also added to the list. We've also added to the list all of these new forms of technology, these new platforms, right? These new ways of reaching out into our communities. And I'm excited about it.
Yeah, me too, Wendy. And I think you really hit on it that, I think a lot of us were very hesitant to use the new technology, but I think a lot of engineering is actually applying that engineering. And so hopefully moving forward, we won't be so hesitant to apply the engineering and try new things out. Because like you said, we can try it out, and if it doesn't work, then we can go back and try something different. So we've got all these opportunities ahead of us, and I think we can use the best of it. So It's been so nice talking to you today, and thanks for talking with me about engineering for this CRR week.
That's my stop talking alarm.
Look at that. We're right on time.
There you are. All right. Well, happy CRR week, everybody. Embrace the engineering, and we'll talk to you all again soon.
Bye, everyone.